During an interview with Newsmax host Eric Bolling this week, Donald Trump confirmed that he will not be participating in the first presidential debate, although he wants to, and he hasn't officially made up his mind. But what he told Eric Bolling does indicate that Donald Trump will not even be eligible to participate in the debate, because Donald Trump says that he will not be signing the loyalty pledge that is a requirement to stand on that debate stage. And that loyalty pledge, of course, says that you will support whoever the eventual nominee is. Here's what Trump told Bolling. I wouldn't sign the pledge. They want you to sign a pledge, but I can name three or four people that I wouldn't support for president. So right there, there's a problem. Now, earlier in the week, Donald Trump had been out there whining about certain other Republican presidential candidates, Mike Pence, of allegedly being disloyal. That's a phrase, by the way, a term that Donald Trump uses quite frequently to describe people that used to work for him, but now they don't. He says they're all disloyal. He's accused Ron DeSantis of being disloyal. And here he is literally saying, I am not going to be loyal to my own political party. I am, in fact, going to be disloyal, and I'm not going to pledge to support your eventual nominee. Now, here's the thing. It's not just, and I think this might be the bigger issue for Donald Trump in signing the pledge, because you're not only agreeing to support the eventual nominee. I mean, the eventual nominee is going to be Donald Trump, so yeah, he doesn't necessarily have to do it. The other part is an agreement that you will not participate in any other debates or forums that have not been approved by the Republican National Committee. And you're not going to participate in, you know, the presidential debates put on by the Commission for Presidential Debates, which has put on the debate since the 80s. It's a nonpartisan group. And that's the part I think that Donald Trump has a bigger problem with. He's trying to make it about the loyalty part of the pledge, but really, Trump wants any and all media attention that he can get, and the RNC is trying to limit that for some stupid reason. In fact, the stupid reason they're trying to limit it actually has everything to do with Donald Trump, who's gone out there and attacked these other media outlets and the Commission on Presidential Debates. So the RNC tried to cater to him and be like, okay, well, we'll put this in the pledge. And he's like, well, no, I mean, I'll still do it because I love the attention. I mean, hell, he even told Bolling, he went further, he goes, I'd like to do it. I've actually gotten very good marks on debating talents. No, you haven't. They want a smart president. They want somebody that's going to be smart. Somebody that's going to be smart, as opposed to somebody that already is smart. I mean, you need to watch how you phrase things. But either way, Donald Trump, you're not a good debater. You're the analogy of playing chess with a pigeon. Because at the end of it, the pigeon's just going to knock all the pieces off the board, strut around, crap all over the board, and act like they won. That's what you do on the debate stage. You're not actually sitting there arguing policy and arguing, you know, the intricacies of American foreign policies. No, no, no. You're just sitting there like, Christie's fat. He's probably eating, like you said in your debate earlier today. Or not earlier today, but rally earlier the week. Excuse me. You'd be like, Mike Pence is disloyal. He had the authority to do it and he didn't do it. Oh, little Ron Meatball de Sanctimonious can't even fight Mickey Mouse. Like, those are the things you do. That's not debating. That's just name calling. And it may work for you in the Republican primaries. It 100% does. Doesn't work for you on the national stage, which is why the RNC wants to prevent you from having to go on a debate stage against President Biden. But it is a qualification. If you do not sign the pledge, you're not allowed to debate. So if Donald Trump wants to participate, he's either going to have to convince the RNC to drop the pledge requirement, which I do feel they would do for him, or he's going to have to bite the bullet and just sign it. Because Donald Trump doesn't want to miss out on that debate stage. He's talked a big game against it. He gets his crowds at his rallies to tell him no when he asks if he should participate. But it drives him crazy to think that everybody's going to be tuned into this event and they're not going to see him. His desire to be in the spotlight is eventually going to become so overwhelming that he will do what it takes to put himself on that stage. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified
every time a new video goes up.